lifted in here. Lift it. Come on, just the voices. Sing it. Come on. Yet again, not seeking what man has, what man wants or desires, but Lord, we come to seek you. What is your desire? What is your purpose? That's what we pursue tonight. Lord, we're tired of church as usual. Continue to manifest greatly in our presence as we come seeking you in yours. Lord, I thank you for signs, wonders, miracles. I thank you that they haven't been done away with. We thank you that we are continuing to write Acts, the book of Acts, from chapter 29 on. We're continuing to write and to record the book of Acts. And I thank you, Lord, right now in Jesus' name, that every single person in here wakes up spiritually, is refreshed to a new level, a refirement, a fresh fire coming on each and every one of us right now. I thank you for it in Jesus' name. Oh Lord. Glorify you. Come on, lift your hands and just receive that. Take a deep breath in and just receive fresh fire tonight. All oppression go. All depression go. All demonic assignments broken in Jesus' name. Father, we thank you for tonight. The revival is not coming, but revival is here right now. We thank you that the north side is on fire with the power and the presence of Almighty God. I thank you that this church, although it's 30 years old, is starting fresh, a new level, just getting started in Jesus' name. And I thank you, Lord, also for the Word of God and the Spirit of God together, not separate, but one. Can join forces. As we break open the manna from heaven tonight, I thank you, Lord, that it's spoken boldly through me, unhindered, uninterrupted by any satanic, demonic, or religious traditional force. And we have ears to hear, but we're not hearers only. We're doers. We have ears to hear, but our hearts are open to what you have to say. We have hearts that are open, ears that are open, and a mind that is open, a will that will do what we hear tonight. We are doers of your word, not hearers only. Thank you for fresh revelation knowledge continuing to flow freely. Thank you for the pastors of this house. Thank you, Lord, for Pastors James and Marilyn Hill and the work you've called them to and the work that you've called them to, not just locally but abroad. This is a local church with a world vision. Thank you, Lord, for strengthening, encouraging, freshly anointing and equipping both of them as we honor them as shepherds you have over this house in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Well, lift your hands and thank you. Glory to God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory. Thank you, Steph, for coming and being a part of this. And sister, thank you so much. Let me see. No, it's definitely your anointing. Praise God. Glory, glory, glory. Well, we're in for a special treat tonight, as we have been every night. Amen. I'm glad both of you said amen. Like everybody else, we're going to say amen with those two. Amen? Amen. Glory to God. Well, thank you, Pastor James, again. I know some stuff tried to hit the house. Should I go ahead and switch over to my headset, Brother Derek? Thank you, Lord Jesus. Glory, glory, glory. I think I'm on. Hallelujah. All right. Some stuff tried to hit, you know, and I'm not saying that that's not... Some of it's life. Some of it's just demonic, but some of it just simply happens because that's what happens, and you know, the pastors as good shepherds are there to take care of the sheep. What do you do when some junk happens and yet you got a Wednesday night meeting or even a revival that's been assigned to this night and to this church? Amen. And that's you. It's not just me, right? Come on now. The point isn't that I come and I'm just all full of revival and I dance around and you all watch me have it. It's about you having the impartation of revival too, because I'm looking at a bunch of revivalists in here tonight. And again, I thank both of you that said amen earlier that said amen again. I said, I'm looking at a bunch of revivalists in here tonight. And so the thing is, with that, revival, if you continue to pray for it to come, you have not fully accepted the fact that it's here. If you continue to go, thank you, Steph, I appreciate all your work. You can finish later with us. Hallelujah. Let's give her a big God bless you. Amen. She's also a very good drummer. You know, like Derek said, not as good as him, but still, she's a very good drummer. And I see your head back there. If you had the hair on, I wouldn't see you at all. That window right there is jet black right behind you, man. But anyway, if you're constantly praying for revival to come, you haven't fully accepted the revelation that revival is here. Now, this is all free. This part's free. Somebody say amen. Amen. And I'm going to give you a discounted message with an undiscounted fire. Come on now. But here's what happens when we're continually praying that revival come. Lord, send revival. Then we've missed the fact that the Holy Ghost is revival. We've missed the fact that Jesus is revival. Now, if I continually, now this is a little sketchy. I know having taught at Rhema at healing school for those years and whatnot, sometimes this can get a little tricky, and I don't want to mess up your theology to where you leave more confused about a topic. But I want you to understand that your healing is already here. How do you know? Because who's the healer? Who died for your healing? Who took all sickness and disease upon him? Come on, oh, I love how you say it. I can just hear the victory up in here tonight. Come on, who's your healer?
Jesus.
Who took all sickness and disease? Well, then how did that happen if you weren't even born yet? Because he's just that good. He took on all future sickness and disease, stuff that hadn't even had a name yet. He took it and had a category of 39 stripes across his back. Every name of sickness fits within those 39 categories. And whatever stripe he took across his back, that sickness will fit underneath that category. And he took it across his back so you wouldn't have to take it in your body. And so when he took that into him, he hung on the cross with that sickness. You remember that powerful night? We all saw our sickness in his body. We saw our pain in his body. And then when he cried out, "It is finished," we saw it die in his body. Come on, out of ours into his. The great substitution. When he died and went to hell for 3 days, you know, I guarantee you the altar call was something like this. Every head up, every eye looking around. Every hand went up. Come on. Led captivity captive. And on the third day rose again, seated at the right hand of the Father. Because when he said it is finished, he took care of it. It is done. So your healing isn't coming, but your manifestation may appear to be coming. But the fact is, if I keep praying for my healing, I haven't accepted the fact that I'm healed, irrelevant of how I feel. And so this is, how many of y'all go to work regardless of how you feel? Oh, there's a good illustration in there somewhere. How many of y'all serve a boss that you don't really care for, but you submit anyway in respect because of his position? Come on. All right. Hallelujah. How many of you been there before when you were hoping that that paycheck came anyway, even though your heart attitude and your head attitude towards your boss wasn't as good as it could have been, and he still paid you anyway, even with some attitudes he may or may not have been aware of? Come on. But the thing is, thank God, Jesus took all of it. He took all the attitudes, all the sickness, all the disease, all the illness, all the pain, all the junk, all the oppression, everything into his body, and then he went and paid for it so you wouldn't have to. So when are you healed? Well, I am now. But brother, I don't feel like it. You're going to hear me cover this until we get it. It's called hammer time. Look at your neighbor and say, it's hammer time. Look at your other neighbor and say, can't touch this. All right, now, Glory, glory, glory. So here now, before I invite up some dear friend, peer ministers, they're getting ready to bless you, kind of put a kink, so to speak, in your necklace, a little bit different than maybe what you're used to on a Wednesday night. That's why I invited them. We did a meeting last night. They came out and they tore it up. I'd never heard them, never seen them before, but I do know the Spirit bore witness, and my goodness, the Holy Ghost was all over those guys, and these young men are full of the Word. And you're not going to believe this. Two of them are white. That was a miracle in and of itself. Now, the one that's on steroids, don't judge him. I don't think he does them anymore. But anyway. I'm going to invite Rebirth to come on up and tear it up for you tonight. All right. Just let them minister to you. Woo! These folks are the spoken word. They are the rhema with a B. Oh, you didn't get that, did you? I said, it's a rhema with a beat. Come on, look at your neighbor and go. All right, now. David, Corey, Chris. Give it up for Rebirth. While they're getting started, I'm going to let you know a couple of those guys were on the street, and I'll let you pick which ones you think that is. And they got saved not too long ago, but they hear the word coming out of these young men at such a young age of not only being born again, but a young age chronologically. It'll mess with you. It's good. So, again, Rebirth.
How you doing? All right. I heard this is a revival. How many believers do we have here tonight? Yeah. Nobody's dead, right? Everybody's revived? Yeah. Everybody alive?
Yeah.
Alright. This song we're going to do now is called More Than a Conqueror. And basically the words go like this. I once was blind, but you opened my eyes. I was dead, but you made me alive. And now I can see. We're more than conquerors. So every time we say, and now I can see, I want y'all to say, more than conquerors, because we are more than conquerors through everything that comes our way, through any tribulation, we are more than a conqueror through Christ Jesus. Take it away, brother.
In life, yeah, we are faced with tribulation.
We are.
But don't lose heart.
Yeah.
Because he,
Jesus,
is overcame the world.
Jesus.
Jesus Christ, brother.
Yeah.
Again. I was dead, but you made me alive. Once was blind, but you opened my eyes. And now I can see.
We're more than conquerors. We're more than conquerors. We're more than conquerors. We're more than conquerors.
I was down, but you gave me joy.
Who is it?
voice in our seats.
If you believe in God, we're more than conquerors. We're more than conquerors. We're more than conquerors.
We're more than conquerors. And through our Lord Jesus, the devil has no power. On the cross, he was defeated. To all believers in Jesus, the heavenly seated. He's redeemed us and brings us victory in his new plan. Made a new creation. We have crucified the old man. Take a stand. Never lose a battle with the greater end. So take his hand. Holy Spirit, lead us to the promise. The greater one inside. Encouraging
him. You know you can.
Giving me a spirit.
Yeah, I'm seeing things from his view.
Family of God should be locked tight like super glue. All across the world. No longitude, no latitude. I've had it too. And it's a win. I'll take my attitude. My heavy heart is aching. Speaking of my Lord's passion. Have to do this now. Faith requires action. Without work is dead. I gotta make this happen.
Yeah.
No longer this.
That neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other created thing shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. Thank you guys. That was More Than Conquerors. And this second song we wrote, it's called Take a Stand, and we just wrote this to inspire the body of Christ to step out of their comfort zones and to start preaching the Word of God and loving people, because there's a lost and dying generation out there, and I know that we all see it. We're trying to hide from it. We're trying to live in our Christian box when God's trying to kick us out there and do our thing. The Great Commission we've been called to. We try to ignore that scripture and not read it, but we know we're called to go out and preach and to minister to lives just like we've been ministered to. Because if those people didn't come to us,
yeah,
we wouldn't be here tonight.
Yeah.
Maybe we need to start opening our own eyes and quit telling other people to open their eyes. You know what I'm saying? So this song is called Take a Stand, and we pray that this will come and hit your heart.
And you get up out of your seats.
It's time to speak up. All my Christians get louder. Teach about Christ every second, minute, hour. Spreading his love. Let's make our Father even prouder. God wants this for our war. Holy Ghost power. God is stepping thing. It's time we take a stand. Proclaiming his name. So give out the great I am. So reach out. That's the great need of your hand. And put that on my heart. Front line as we stand. I pray that this will hit you. It's time we stand. Yeah.
Spirit to confirm.